What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about upgrading SCCM to 24.03. So let's get right into it. All right, so a couple of weekends ago, I decided to set up my lab and I wanted to check on my SCCM to upgrade it to 24.03. I've been reading a lot of articles online stating that 24.03 has been providing a lot of issues, especially when you upgrade it. The Microsoft Manager console doesn't load up, it crashes. So I wanted to see what was going on to see if it happens to me to create additional videos on how to fix it. Okay, let's get right into it, right? So the first thing that I did is you need to download the latest and greatest .NET framework. From this page right here, we're going to locate download.framework 4.8 runtime. We're going to click on that and we're going to download it. Now, I already downloaded it within my SCCM server. So I went inside my downloads folder, I located the .exe file, I right-clicked on it, and I ran it as an administrator, and the installation will not occur because I already have the latest and greatest .NET framework. Just make sure you have it. I just wanted to make sure that I have the latest and greatest, so right here, I'm good to go. So I closed this up, and on the desktop, I clicked on the start menu, I clicked on Configuration Manager Console to load it up. Now, on your left-hand side, we're going to click on Administration. Within Administration, let's click on Updates and Servicing. So once I got inside the Updates and Servicing, I noticed that 24.03 was downloading. So I actually had to wait until the state changed to ready to install. So if you have been tuning in and watching my videos, I love to just right-click on this guy and just do Install Update Pack. The reason why is because it's going to automatically run the pre-check for you. So why do that first and then do the update? Yes, you could do the pre-check and if it catches any errors, fix it and then you're able to install. I like to just go straight into it and just install the update pack. You're going to get the Configuration Manager Updates Wizard. I typically, if you've been seeing me and watching me, I love to just check, ignore any prerequisite checks, warnings, and install the update regardless of missing requirements. I just like doing this. I click next here. Now for features, I typically leave everything as blank. You are able to enable whatever you want during this upgrade, but it all depends on how you want your environment. So I'm going to click next here. For the client update settings, I typically leave it as upgrade without validating and then click next here. For the license and terms, let's click on I accept these license and terms, click next here. For the cloud attached settings, I basically uncheck this because I don't have any cloud settings configured as of yet. Click next, a nice little summary, click next here, green check mark, which is always a good thing, but once it starts installing, that's when the problems occur. We're going to close this up. So once you close it up, give it some time, the state will change to installing and eventually it's gonna start checking for the pre-checks. That's good. So for me, right, it happened, it failed. I was like, oh no, what happened? What failed? So on the lower right-hand side where it says related objects, underneath that, let's click on show status. It's going to take us here. We're going to right-click on this and click on show status. Pre-check failed. So let's select it. Let's scroll all the way down until we see what's going on. Now for me, what failed was the company resource access policies are no longer supported. So the version that I'm going to, the company resource policies are not supported anymore. So I basically just clicked OK from here. Once I clicked OK, I clicked on administration. I went into the management insight. I clicked on all insight and I wanted to basically figure out what was not supported anymore. So I right clicked on unsupported features. I clicked on show insights. It took me here and I noticed that something had action needed. So I selected it. And it's basically the company resource access policies are no longer supported. That's the issue that I'm having upgrading to 24.03. So I right-clicked on it. I did more details. Now, my problem is these two profiles that I created for you guys a while back. So I selected the Wi-Fi profile and I clicked on review actions, which took me to the company resource access folder. So I opened that up. I went into the VPN profiles. There goes that profile that's giving me problems. So I right-clicked on it and I clicked on delete and I clicked on yes, it's gone. So the next one that I need to take care of is the Wi-Fi profile. So I select the Wi-Fi profile. There goes the profile that's giving me problems. So I right-clicked on it and selected delete and clicked OK. Once both profiles were deleted, I went back into the administration and I selected the company resource access is not supported, the one that needed attention. So I right-clicked on it and I selected reval. It started doing its thing. Eventually, it said completed, no action needed. That was great. So I headed back into updates and servicing. I selected my updates. Again, on the lower right-hand side, I clicked on show status. It took me here again. I right-clicked on it and I selected retry installation. I clicked on OK. It started doing its thing. If you head back into administration, updates and servicing, select your update. It is checking for the pre-check, which is good. Eventually, it should change to installing. Now, once it changes to installing and you don't get any issues, I would say go grab lunch, go grab a cup of coffee, or go do something else because this process does take a while. Eventually, it's going to prompt you the following. It wants you to update the console. So click OK. Everything will close. I always have this problem. For some reason, the manager never closes right away. So I typically have to right-click on the taskbar and then select Task Manager, locate it, which is right here. It's still running. I right-click on it, and I end the task and then close the Task Manager and then click on Retry. Once I do that, it checks if the manager console is up and running. If it's not, it's going to start downloading the files. Eventually, it changes to preparing to install, and then it starts installing. It starts updating the extensions. If everything works well, your management console should load up. Once it loads up, on the upper left-hand side, I like to click on the, I call this like the file tab button, but it takes you here. And I like to click on About Configuration Manager. It tells you which version you are, which is great. 2403, that's what we wanted. I clicked OK to get out of here. And the next thing I like to do is go back into administration, updates and servicing, and long and behold, we have Configuration Manager 2403. The state is installed. Now, next thing that I like to do is go into the software. Within software, let's go into operating systems. Inside operating systems folder, let's go into the boot images. Select your boot image. For me, I like to do the boot image 64. I right-click on it. I select update distribution points. I click next here. I click next. It's going to start doing this thing, and eventually you should get this green check mark, and then click on close, and then you're good to go. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I didn't receive any of the issues that I saw online. I think one of the major issues is that if you have MDT integrated within SCCM, you're going to have a lot of issues. I don't have MDT integrated within my SCCM, so I didn't receive a lot of those issues. But everything was successful. I did do a test to make sure deployment was successful, which was great. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.